Hi, my name is Shez. You're watching Project Food Garden. Today is a Saturday. It's 8th of December 2021. We wanted to do a quick episode over the indoor germination, the plants that you germinate yourself, versus the seedlings that you get from the DIY stores or the nurseries. And we will just share our experience with you guys. I mean, I'm not trying to, you know, slag down the seedlings that you get from the store, or trying, you know, blow the trumpet for the seedlings that I germinate indoor. It's just about what I have learned over the last 2 years. We'll share that with you today. So let's get on with it. Number one, the benefit of doing your own seedlings. You are pretty much in charge of the schedule. You know when you can put the seedlings in. The idea for telling you this is you can stay ahead of the schedule. Always start the indoor germination 8 to 6 weeks prior to the kickoff of the season. Number two, once the seedlings are germinated, you are in control of what you're feeding to the seedlings. So what I've done this year is that apart from what I've given them is the seaweed juice, which helps in root development. So when you are feeding the seedlings with the quality feed, the health of the seedlings is so much better as compared with what you get from the stores. So if you are growing a lot of veggies in the garden, bringing so many seedlings from the store can be a pricey proposition. So cost effectiveness is the third thing that comes into play. A punnet of say 6 seedlings in the start of the season, it can be anywhere from $5 to $10, whereas if you bring a packet of seeds from which you can grow 50 plants, it's not more than $3. So the benefit which comes on top of everything is that when you start the season early, you get to harvest early. I mean, we started our strawberry patch this year because we had plants from the last year. So we started off the patch in July, and by the time we the third week of September, we were harvesting. So the point that I'm trying to tell you is germinating your own seedlings, staying in control, gives you a much better chance to get early harvest. So the third most important thing when you're procuring the seed, always read the label. By reading the label means that procure heirloom variety seeds. Do not procure hybrid. I mean, that's my opinion. I've got amazing yield, and I have moved away from procuring the hybrid seed. And whatever I have germinated in the garden, we'll show you in a sec, it's all from heirloom seeds. So you can see in the background, I've got my tomato patch. I have germinated 98% of the seedlings myself, and the process started off in August, and by the time we hit the bank holiday or the labor weekend, they were ready to be planted out. But nonetheless, we were quite wary of the weather, so we got them out on 7th of November. Now, apart from that, the list of veggies that I have done with in the household that started off, I mean, we did the cleaning in June and July. We had the strawberry planter set up in July, and then we started off. So I've done from seed, I've done my green peas, my elephant garlic, normal garlic, of course, tomatoes, and we had daikon, we had radish, we had purple haze carrots, baby carrots, we had aubergines, then we had Russian black cream, then we had loads of beetroot, 10 or 11 different kind of chilies. And you know, it's been such an ease that everything that I've grown is in my control, in my greenhouse, and I am in control of the schedule, and I will get the plants out. You know, sometimes you bring the seedlings. A good friend of mine here in Christchurch, he bought the seedlings of aubergine, he planted them out, maybe he was misguided by somebody, and they died straight away, and the seedlings were finished because of up and down in the temperature. So whatever we are doing, we are covering everything for you with every week. So bottom line is, if you germinate your own plants, the health, it's in your control. The diet is in your control. You know what you're growing. It's cost effective. And above all, the production that you get from the home germinated seeds, absolutely brilliant. I'm not talking just for the heck of it, you can visit my previous episodes of the Russian black creme tomatoes and the moneymaker that we had done in the house last year. So on that note, I hope you'll find this episode useful. If you have not done so, and if you like the content that we are sharing in this season, do give us a click, subscribe to the channel if you like, and wherever you are, stay safe out there in the pandemic. We have a new variant out, so wear a mask when you go out, take precautions, and take care of yourself. Have a lovely morning, afternoon, evening, and night, wherever you are. Goodbye.